Hey guys, it's me, Robotic Gold John, whichever you prefer. I'm back at it with another Knights of the Old Republic video. I've been looking back at the older ones, and I'm thinking, wow, I could have done these way better. So we're going to restart, we're going to cut a lot of this stuff out, mainly the walking, the fighting's going to stay in, hopefully. Maybe if it's too long, I'll cut that out too. Like, subscribe, hit that bell. And this time, instead of light side, we're going to do like a mixture. Like, we're going to go gray more. Try to balance it out a little. Make it a little interesting. Yeah. It's going to be fun. I think this first bit, I'm just going to try to keep all the important stuff in. Like the title sequence. The dialogue. But everything else is going to get cut out, so I'm gonna mute and speak when I need to.
We've been ambushed by a Sith battle fleet. The Endar Spire is under attack. Hurry up, we don't have much time. Did you fall out of your bunk and hit your head? The Endar Spire is the ship we're stationed on. This ship. You probably don't even know who I am, do you? I'm Trask Ulgo, ensign with the Republic fleet. I'm your bunkmate here on the Endar Spire. We work opposite shifts. I guess that's why you haven't seen me before. Now hurry up! We have to find Bastila. We have to make sure she makes it off the ship alive. You swore an oath to protect Bastila when you signed up with this mission, just like everyone else in the crew. Now it's time to make good on that oath. I know she may not have an official rank in the fleet, but she's the one in charge of this mission, and it's our duty to protect her. I heard what everyone's saying about you. You've explored the farthest reaches of the galaxy. You've visited planets I've never even heard of. People with your skills and abilities are hard to find. It's no wonder the Republic recruited you for this mission. But now's the time to prove yourself. I know you're a scout and not a soldier, but Bastila needs all troops at her side during this attack. So hurry up and grab your gear. You need to suit up so we can get out of here. Okay, let's move out. We should stick together. You'll have... Because of the attack, this room is in lockdown. But don't worry, I've got the override codes. You'll have to use me to unlock the door. Now that the door is open, you better take the lead again.
This is Carthel Nassi. The Sith are threatening to overrun our position. We can't hold out long against their firepower. All hands to the bridge!
That was Karth contacting us on our portable communicators. He's one of the Republic's best pilots. He's seen more combat than the rest of the Endar Spire's crew put together. If he says things are bad, you better believe it. We have to get to the bridge to help defend Bastila. There's a map of the Endar Spire and a copy of Karth's message in your electronic journal, just in case we get separated. It's a dark Jedi! This fight is too much for us! We better stay back! All we do is get in the way! That was one of the Jedi accompanying Bastila. Damn, we could have used her help! Bastila's not here on the bridge. They must have retreated to the escape pods. We better head that way, too. The Sith want Bastila alive, but once she's off the ship, there's nothing stopping them from blasting the Endar Spire into galactic dust.
Okay, I'm gonna... So this is the point where... This is actually where I can die now. So once you've leveled up, there's no turning back from death. Destruction. Mayhem, and from death, I lost that. I didn't have any more ideas for words to use. I love how in this part you actually don't fight any of these Republic or Sith soldiers, and you still get the experience for killing them. It's kind of funny. Okay, bye, Trask. Ripping pepperonis, big.
Something behind here.
Big T.
Damn, another dark Jedi. I'll try to hold him off. You get to the escape pods. Go.
Why did I say big T?
This is Carthel Nassi on your personal communicator. I'm tracking your position through the Endar Spire's life support systems. Bastila's escape pod is away. You're the last surviving crew member on the Endar Spire. Now, I can't wait for you much longer. You have to get to the escape pods.
Remember, from the original first episode, this is a tutorial, kind of. Don't give him an energy shield, because he already has one. Watch this. See that? He already has one. Life hack for this video game. It's amazing what you can learn from playing a game for almost 6 years. For a while there, this was my favorite game of all time. It's still really good. I play Skyrim a lot more, though.
You've made it just in time. There's only one active escape pod left. Come on, we can hide out on the planet below. I'm a soldier with the Republic, like you. We're the last two crew members left in the Endar Spire. Bastila's escape pod's already gone, so there's no reason for us to stick around here and get shot by the Sith. Now, come on! There'll be time for questions later.
This is where the game begins. There's a lot of cutting for this first bit, because it's 20 minutes of basically useless content. Woohoo! I'm gonna cut a lot of stuff. It's probably gonna be like 5 minutes when I'm done. Probably gonna cut most of the fighting from this tutorial bit. A lot of the dialogue's gonna stay in, except for stuff like tutorials from Trask. I don't know. That stuff is dumb. No one wants to watch that. Dream time. We're off to dreamy land, boys. Off to dreamy land. You guys may have noticed that Kevin Bacon's name isn't weird and jumbled.
Good to see
it's
you.
Because I'm not dumb this time.
Thrashing about in your sleep. You must have been having one hell of a nightmare. I was wondering if you were ever going to wake up. I'm Karth, one of the Republic soldiers from the Endar Spire. I was with you in the escape pod. Do you remember?
I had a strange dream, like a vision or something. No. It's too naive. It's too, how I say, dumb. You don't tell people that you have dreams. I mean, especially people that you barely know. Like, visions and stuff. I know it's Star Wars. I mean, the rules change a bit. But it's dumb. So we're gonna go with the names. First name basis.
Been slipping in and out of consciousness for a couple of days now, so I imagine you're pretty confused about things. Try not to worry. We're safe. At least for the moment. We're in an abandoned apartment on the planet of Terrace. You were banged up pretty bad when our escape pod crashed, but luckily I wasn't seriously hurt. I was able to drag you away from our crash site in all the confusion, and I stumbled into this abandoned apartment. By the time the Sith arrived on the scene, we were long gone.
I owe you my life. The Sith. We're not indentured servants. We're not gonna be a frickin' Wookiee. We're a gosh darn gray Jedi. A gosh darn gray Jedi.
Terrace is under Sith control. Their fleet is orbiting the planet. They've declared martial law and they've imposed a planet-wide quarantine. But I've been in worse spots. I saw on your service records that you understand a remarkable number of alien languages. That's pretty rare in a raw recruit. But it should come in handy while we're stranded on a foreign world. There is no way the Republic will be able to get anyone through the Sith blockade to help us. If we're gonna find Bastila and get off this planet, we can't rely on anybody but ourselves.
Why is it important to find Bastila? Yeah, it's probably the best one.
That smack to your head did more damage than I thought. Bastila's a Jedi. She was with the strike team that killed Darth Revan, Malak's Sith master. Bastila's the key to the whole Republic war effort. The Sith must have found out that she was on the Endar Spire and set an ambush for us in this system. I believe Bastila was on one of the escape pods that crashed down here in Terrace. For the sake of the Republic war effort, we have to try and find her.
Because we're a gray Jedi, we're going to say something like, she could probably look out for herself. I mean, she said that the first time we met her, but whatever. We're forgetting our past life, okay? We're not going to remember what was. We're going to remember what will be.
Bastila's gonna need our help. Many of Darth Malak's followers have mastered the dark side of the Force, and the Sith have already killed more than their share of Jedi in this war. I doubt anyone's specifically looking for us anymore. We're not that important. But if we're careful, we can move about the planet without attracting notice, a luxury Bastila won't have. She's gonna have half the Sith fleet looking for her. They know how vital she is to the war effort. Bastila's no ordinary Jedi. She has a rare gift the Jedi call battle meditation. Bastila's power can influence entire armies.
I was texting. Apparently, my microphone was still on. I didn't even notice that. Battle meditation.
If Bastila's so great, how could the Sith manage to blow up the inner space?
Through the Force, Bastila can inspire her allies with confidence and make her enemies lose their will to fight. And often that's all it takes to tip the balance in a battle. But there are limits to what she can do. From what I understand of her ability, it requires great concentration and focus to maintain her battle meditation. The attack on the Endar Spire happened so fast, she probably never even had a chance to use her power. I'm guessing she barely got out alive, and now she's trapped here just as we are. The whole planet is under quarantine. No ships can land or take off. So if Bastila's gonna escape Terrus, she's gonna need our help, and we'll probably need hers.
I'm not a jerk. Whoa, that was loud. Okay.
Good. We're gonna need to work together if we're gonna survive. While you were out, I did some scouting around. There are reports of a couple escape pods crashing down into the Undercity. It's probably a good place to start. But the Undercity's a dangerous place. We don't want to go there unprepared, and it won't do Bastila any good if we go and get ourselves killed.
Soon, we start looking for Bastila. Soon, we'll find her. Let's freaking do this.
Good idea. We can use this abandoned apartment as a base. We can probably get some equipment and supplies here in the upper city. Just remember to keep a low profile. I've heard some grim stories about the Dark Jedi interrogation techniques. They say the Force can do terrible things to a mind. It can wipe away your memories and destroy your very identity. But I figure if we don't do anything stupid, we should be okay. I mean, after all, they're looking for Bastila, not a couple of grunts like us. All right, soldier, let's move out.
I'm the captain around these parts. You're not gonna tell me what to do. I'm the captain around these parts. I outrank you by. I invoke Jedi privileges. I am the commanding officer on this here ship. You frickin' turd butt face.
Okay, I'm gonna be back. My computer's kind of overheating, so I'm gonna let it cool down. We're gonna get back into this. I'm gonna watch the video, maybe cut it down a little bit before I make the next bit. Okay, it'll just be like seeing if I can fit more into this. So, I'll see you in a bit. You may be thinking, where's the game? Well, the video is kind of long, so this is an outro. I'll see you guys in the next one.